next time I come, I'm gonna fish with braided line, maybe 15-pound braid tied to a leader or a small little ant swivel, and use my 6 and 8 pound fluorocarbon, because that real deep stuff, when the wind's blowing like that, it's blowing your rod, you just don't feel those sensitive bites. And again, that's a light bite day. If they're biting heavy and stuff, you feel that traditional knock, you know, lean down, count to one Mississippi, two Mississippi, and a lot of times, that little hook will find its mark. You'll catch those walleyes. There he is too. And not bad.
Not bad.
Oh yeah, that doesn't feel bad, really. Doesn't feel bad at all. Good bite too. Maybe 17, 18. That's what it feels like. But you never know, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
Just a bigger eater, but we got enough teeth, don't we? That jig is just, look at that.
Just
corner of the mouth. Yeah. I fooled him that time. He didn't fool me. Little walleye. So we're gonna put one of these in the box. It's about what? 16?
Yeah. What, 16, 17.
Yeah. Throw out one of those small guys. Come here, you. You get in there. You come here. Call him out. Go on. See ya. Keep our four. That's all we need. Right on. It is so important on a fishery like this to consider catch and release, and they've got a law too, or say a rule, which is a law up here. No walleyes over 18, no incidental stuff, seriously. You gotta preserve a trophy fishery like this with catch and release. Got him, Willie?
Yeah,
good one?
A little bit bigger, maybe.
Yeah, okay. I'll get the net, yeah. Uh-oh. Big walleye?
No, not really big. No.
Just a nice walleye?
Yeah.
Just a nice walleye, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, nice, nice slow release. Perfect. Beautiful. We have Manotak. That's where you catch the walleyes here, man. And miss some big fish, but hit them. That's the opportunity. You never know on a hook set when you're gonna get the big guy here, but we're getting eaters, 17s, 20. Who knows what's next? Let's keep fishing and let's get some more fish. And I'm just barely touching it. Like, I mean, barely moving the rod. Just enough to make that little jig just go like this off the bottom. And I'm dragging a little bit and stopping. That's it. No fancy stuff. Not a lot of vertical jigging and stuff. Just slow and go. And when they bite, it's all of a sudden a sensation. Crucial, crucial. You gotta be close to that bottom. That's where they're just going along. When you feel that bite, stop. Wait. I open the bail sometimes, but I don't let them wait too long. A couple seconds, feel the weight like that, and then hit them like that. Another, maybe we'll call up another eater, Willie.
Another eater?
I think he's another 16. Look.
Oh yeah.
Hey?
Oh, we have lots for shore lunch if we needed them.
Yeah.